Now let's cover child AED. We're gonna say that this child has already been in cardiac arrest, 911 has been activated, and AED was brought to us, and CPR has been in progress. So we're still gonna make sure that the scene is safe now to be able to use an automated external defibrillator, which means no combustible gases or fluids, and the child is not laying in standing water. If they were, we would drag them to a place of dryness, dab them off so they're not dripping wet, and then we'll prepare to use the AED. When the AED arrives on scene, the very first thing that we do is we turn it on. There's one thing we need to note though, and that is there's sometimes two different size pads in the AEDs. One's for adult and one's for infants or children. The differentiation point is whether they're under or over 55 pounds. Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking the same thing I am. I don't have a scale, how do I know? We're just guessing. If you estimate that they're less than 55 pounds, use the pediatric pads. If they're greater than that, the adult pads. If all you have is adult pads, you're gonna use the adult pads on an infant, a child, and an adult. It's just fine. So here we go. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna place the AED by our patient and we're gonna turn it on.
Remove clothing from person's chest.
If I have scissors, I like to cut it because we don't know if there's a spinal cord injury.
Pads firmly to person's chest as shown.
I grab the pads, I open them up. This child is about 65 pounds, so I'm gonna place it like I would an adult.
Check connector and pads.
Make sure they're firmly on the chest. If there's any jewelry, I'm gonna move the jewelry out of the way. And now I'm gonna put the actual electrodes attached to the AED.
Analyzing rhythm. Everyone stand clear.
I make sure that I'm not touching the patient and no one else is either.
Shock advised. Charging. Everyone stand clear. Everyone stand clear. Push the shock button. Shock delivered. Begin 5 cycles of CPR.
If it's in a large child, I'm going to go with 2 hands and do my third of the depth of the chest in compressions. 100 to 120 times in a minute. After my 30 compressions, 28, 29, 30, I'm gonna go ahead and get my CPR shield. Give my 2 rescue breaths, go right back into the chest compressions. 7, 8, 9, 10, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
Analyzing rhythm. Everyone stand clear.
Now that the AED is interrupted, it tells me to stand clear. I stop touching the patient.
No shock advised. Begin 5 cycles of CPR.
Go right back into the CPR. And start doing my CPR the same way we did before. We're gonna do the 30 compressions, a third of the depth of the chest, followed by the 2 rescue breaths, until the AED interrupts us, tells us to stand clear while it analyzes. If a pad begins to loosen up, you can re-tighten it back down so that it's affixed to the chest. But at no point are we gonna remove the AED pads or turn this off. We're going to allow it to stay on while we do CPR. One special note, we're not going to interrupt compressions any longer than we have to, even after the shock is delivered with the AED. We want to go right back into the compressions and minimize those interruptions until EMS arrives and takes over, or the patient begins to respond and starts breathing normally again.